In this video, we're going to look at the catalytic cycle of an enzyme. And an enzyme is simply a biological catalyst, a catalyst being a molecule that accelerates a chemical reaction. Now, that chemical reaction can be either catabolic or anabolic. What we mean by that is that the reactions can be either breaking a substrate molecule down into more than one part, or building molecules, larger molecules, from a substrate pool where we're taking molecules and creating bonds within them. So for instance, digestion would be a process of catalytic events where molecules are broken down into smaller constituent pieces, whereas anabolic reactions such as the building of DNA by DNA polymerase. That would be an anabolic reaction where we're building larger molecules through the creation of bonds. And so we're going to give an example here of a catabolic reaction aided by this enzyme shown by this sort of ovoid structure here. And it's going to bind with our substrate shown here. And that substrate is going to bind to a particular region of this enzyme known as the active site. Now, the active site is actually two things in one. The active site is a binding site. This is a complementary shape or region of the enzyme, a protein, that's complementary in that it matches up with both the structure and the size, the hydrophilicity or the hydrophobicity of this particular substrate, such that that substrate can bind closely with the enzyme at this location. Now, the other part of the active site is the catalytic component. This is the part of the enzyme that actually aids the enzymatic reaction that we're inducing here. And so in this case, again, we're going to be in catabolic. We're going to break a bond in this substrate. But so our catalytic site in this case would be here because we're going to break a bond between the triangle and the square shape here in this substrate molecule. And so we have the binding of the substrate to the enzyme. We have what's called an induced fit model for this, meaning that the enzyme actually changes shape slightly to conform to the substrate. We then form what's called the enzyme substrate complex once that substrate is bound. And then the catalytic event occurs, right? Remember we said the catalytic site would be here in this particular model. And we're breaking that bond between the triangular part of the substrate molecule and this rectangular portion. Now, keep in mind that the enzyme accomplishes this aid to a chemical reaction simply by lowering the activation energy. It just makes it easier for that reaction to occur. It does not change the equilibrium, does not change anything other than the speed with which the reaction takes place. After that bond is broken, in this particular scenario, our substrates would need to be released. And one of the characteristics of a catalytic cycle is that the catalyst itself is reusable. And so this enzyme now, having released the two products, is available for binding again to another substrate molecule. And this can happen hundreds or thousands or even tens of thousands of times per second. So enzymes are very efficient at accelerating chemical reactions in biological scenarios where otherwise the conditions would not allow the events to occur at all, even if they're thermodynamically spontaneous. They would just be too slow without the presence of a catalyst.